Did you know that the custom t-shirt printing market will be worth $6.9 billion in 2027? That's why Big Frog of Portland turns in $500,000 in revenue printing custom tees for corporate events and celebrations. In this two-part series, we are talking to Big Frog's owner, Sanford Booth. Sanford's been in the business for 9 years and today brings in $500,000 of revenue each year printing custom t-shirts. And wait until you hear his take home so far.
The initial cost was around, I think, $180,000 to $200,000.
What's your biggest expense on a monthly basis?
And I was breaking even after my fourth month.
Today we're going to hear how Sanford got involved with the Big Frog brand, and we'll hear his tips on how to start a successful t-shirt business. We'll also see how he's pivoted his marketing over the last year to continue to be profitable through all the 2020 disruptions.
So I do this for 35 seconds, and then I'll push the big green button, or what I call the money button.
After 9 years, what are the advantages, disadvantages that you can share with us in terms of franchising or private? And if you wait until the end of this video, Sanford's going to share with us whether going with a franchise model was a good or bad idea. We're excited to hear Sanford's advice because we may be talking to the next Jeff Bezos. So let's go and meet Sanford Booth. So you guys, we are here with the owner of Big Frogs here in Portland. Sanford, thank you for being with us. Can't wait to share your story. What a fun storefront.
Yeah, so first of all, thanks for having me. Appreciate the opportunity, guys.
Of course.
And, well, Big Frog is a franchise garment decorating business where the concept is you come in with an idea, an image, a logo, a design, or a photograph, and then one of my designers will help you put that onto a t-shirt, a polo, or a hoodie, or some other type of garment that you might be into.
That's awesome. So anything I could think of.
Yeah,
you can print
anything. Yeah, yeah, and the designers are here to help you, you know, make that idea come to life to put onto the garment. You can either bring in a thumb drive, or you maybe have previously emailed us some artwork or something like that, and the graphic designer will pull up that artwork or that idea, and he'll just start going to work.
So him and I are sitting down, and he's listening to what I need, what
correct.
I want.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. And then what's cool is you can see exactly what you're going to be getting. So if there's something you don't like or you want to tweak something, they'll just do it right on the spot for you.
Okay. What does the cost initially look like for you? When did you break even? Those are the two things.
Yeah, so the initial cost was around, I think, $180,000 to $200,000. But there's a franchising fee that comes into play that's, I think, what was at the time, $40,000, $45,000.
Do you pay that up front? Because that seems... You
yep.
do, okay.
Yep, and then there's the build out of this space, which was kind of expensive, and then all the equipment.
How long did it take you to break even, though? So you put in all that money.
It took me, I wasn't making anything for the first couple of months. My break even right now, or back then, was about $18,000, I believe, $18,000. And I was breaking even after my, I believe, fourth month.
$18,000 a month?
Correct.
Wow, okay.
Yeah. So yeah, it's different now.
That's
9 years ago.
That's true, yeah. But man, 4 months into it, you're already breaking even and starting to make a profit.
Yep.
Wow.
Yep, and that's, you know, part of the franchisor's job was to kind of set up and help me with a marketing plan. And, you know, they did a great job in recommending and suggesting what I should do to get out in the community to market and to build the business. And I just followed their template, did what they asked, and it worked.
That's awesome. We'll dive into that as far as franchising a little bit later, but that's pretty cool. I mean, 4 months, that's incredible compared to some other businesses. Let's talk about revenue for you. Year 9 today, or is it year 10?
Yeah, I'm in year 9.
Year 9, okay.
Yeah.
Has your revenue been, where's it at for last year, I guess, since we're just early into this year?
Yeah, so last year I did about $515,000.
Incredible.
I didn't meet my goal. I was going for $550. COVID happened,
yes.
So that's the thing. So I think I did pretty well considering what happened. This year, I think I'll be able to hit my benchmark of 550 for the year. That's my hope, and maybe even
2021.
More.
Okay. Has it been growing steadily? Where did you see big jumps? I mean,
yeah.
Talk to us from year one revenue, just real quick, flying through the years.
So year one, I did 80,000. Year two, I was at 180,000. Year three, I was getting into 300,000. I just started gradually getting up into 400,000 or 500,000.
Mm-hmm.
Year five or six, I can't remember, I did 600,000. I had a couple of really substantial orders and some really big customers that kind of, you know, brought those numbers way up.
Right, but then plateaued back
and
then, to...
And then plateaued, and now I'm back down to, 500,000.
Okay. What's your biggest expense on a monthly basis? And then what does that look like total for the month?
For payroll, we're looking at between, 14 and 16,000 a month. And then as far as lease is concerned, we're at about $3,300 a month for this space. Utilities, we're running at about $600 a month, maybe seven.
So you're creeping up in the 20s.
Yeah, my break even's about 25 to 26,000 a month.
So without making one sale, you need 25 grand.
I gotta push a lot of shirts out.
Wow, yep. Okay. Thinking about awesome t-shirt ideas, or maybe you're just into button-ups, regardless, you guys, we want to remind you to check out our blog at upflip.com/blog, where you can go get all the resources to start a t-shirt business and any other businesses. Also, if you're looking to buy or sell a business, we want to help you with that. Come list with us at upflip.com. All right, you guys, we're going to walk you through the entire process of direct-to-garment printing from the moment the order comes in to when the shirt comes out. So let's check it out.
All right, so this is the pre-treat process. This is the process or the beginning of the printing direct-to-garment white ink. You need to put down a layer of pre-treat, which is an adhesive that allows the white ink to adhere to the garment. So I've got my t-shirt. I'll put it in the pre-treat machine. I'll line it up. And then depending on the size of the art, I'll set the pre-treat sprayer to, on this one I'm doing 16 inches. I'll take the garment, it's wet right now, and what I gotta do is cure it. So I gotta cure that pre-treat. So I do this for 35 seconds, and this'll cure the pre-treat into the garment. And now the shirt's pre-treated and is ready to be printed.
And then I'll push the big green button, or what I call the money button.
That's it? So it's connected to the computer. What are we printing exactly? What's on that screen right there?
We're printing an UpFlip t-shirt for you guys right now.
What you guys see on that screen should be showing up on the t-shirt here. There you go.
But here's the magic, and you can see, I don't know if you want to take the camera and watch the magic happen.
Let's see if we can see it happen.
So it's going to do two passes.
Ah, you just pull it off like that.
Yep, and I'm gonna move over to that heat press. And this parchment paper gives it a little bit of a, more of a matte finish to it.
But now we could fold it, or still trying to be a little careful?
No, like, you can totally.
Can I touch it?
Yeah, it's in there. It's in there forever.
Feels, that's, what did that take us? I mean, on average, one t-shirt, three, four minutes?
Yeah, maybe, well, with the
By the time everything's done.
You're looking at about 4 minutes a shirt, you know.
Okay. All right, you guys, we are going to do a giveaway. Yes, I think it's one of our first giveaways, and we want to do it for our big fans, all of you guys. We're almost at 50,000 subscribers. So we've got five t-shirts collab with UpFlip and Big Frog here in Portland. The way to get into the drawing is just comment below on episode 1 or 2, and we will randomly select five winners to receive this amazing, beautifully, comfortably feeling shirt for you guys. Thank you. Where is your profit margin for direct to garment printing, embroidery, and screen printing?
Yeah, so it fluctuates month to month, you know, depending on if I'm working with nonprofits or schools, you know, margins go down.
Absolutely.
To help them out. But on average, I would say direct to garment printing, I'm hovering around 60-70%. Embroidery,
wow.
Screen printing, I'm probably 45-55%.
Okay. That's pretty good profit margins.
Yeah.
Let's talk real quick about franchising, right? You can either do an independent shop, or you could go franchising like you did with Big Frog. What, for you, after 9 years, what are the advantages, disadvantages that you can share with us in terms of franchising or private?
The benefit of the franchise is you've got a whole system, you've got a whole consortium of stores, where when we partner, or Big Frog partners with Art Garment Decorator, Brother, all sorts of different, you know, the payroll companies. There's a value of having, you know, to pay less when you've got a whole bunch of franchisees that are buying the same product from these companies.
Right.
So we get, you know, special pricing with garments, we get special pricing with Brother, we get special pricing, you know, for payroll services, insurance, you know, things like that.
Any disadvantages you can think of? I mean,
well, the royalty is something to think about.
Right.
You know, that's
probably the only thing.
I pay for that service. You know, at the end of the day, they're in the business of selling franchises to franchisees, but they just do right by their franchisees. And I've been real happy overall with the Big Frog experience and how they've treated me and helped me through the years.
Well, that's a wrap for part one. I hope you guys really enjoyed this interview. Remember, it's not always about scaling and being the biggest business you can be. There is a lot of value in staying small and taking care of your customers. If you haven't already subscribed to our channel, do that for us right now. Hit that like button, comment below, and make sure you check out part two. The link is in the description below, or hit the thumbnail right there.